At the recent ILMB Mortgage Brokering Roadshow, someone asked me one of the questions I used to ask on all my podcasts, which was the Delorean question, which if you remember the movie Back to the Future, the Delorean is the car you get in and you can travel back in time. They said, Scott, if you could travel back in time and give yourself three pieces of advice, what advice would you give yourself? I thought it was a fantastic question, and I'm going to answer that for you in this episode. I'm also going to share with you a couple tools that I would recommend to myself, even though those tools didn't exist 18 years ago, but they're tools you can use today. So I'm going to jump right into this conversation here. Hey, I'm Scott Peckford. This is the ILMB Mortgage Brokering Podcast, the number one podcast for mortgage brokers who want to scale their mortgage business. And I created this podcast 10 years ago now. I'm also the founder of Bricks Mortgage, and I absolutely love helping mortgage brokers and sharing what I learn. I don't know everything, but I share what I can with you guys, and hopefully you find these episodes and conversations useful. So let's just jump into today. For the basically, what would be the three pieces of advice I would give my younger self if I could go back in time? Obviously, you know, I'm going to put aside the idea of like, hey, buy Amazon stock and Apple stock and hold on. But like, that would be great. But if I got to make it mortgage specific, then the thing that I would say, the very first piece of advice that I would give myself is that you hire a coach, hire the most expensive coach you can afford, and listen to everything they say. So let me just give you some quick context on this. You know, there are $1 billion cleaning companies. You know, there are $1 million cleaning companies and $100,000 a year cleaning companies. The problem is not the industry, right? So people are like, oh, you can't do that in the mortgage business. It's all bull crap. You absolutely can. The problem is what you know about your industry that's wrong. And that's so important. I want to repeat it. The problem is what you know or what you think you know about your industry that's wrong. And that's the reason people get stuck at a certain volume or a certain production level. And I got a broker friend, amazing guy, like awesome, awesome dude, still doing pretty much the same number of files he was doing 10 years ago. He has not moved at all. Wonderful human. And the reason is because he will never hire a coach because he thinks he, good guy in one area, but is completely uncoachable in the mortgage space. And I've seen people that have been in the business a fraction of the time as he has and blown right past them. The only reason this guy's volume has actually gone up is because the average mortgage size has gone up, right? So this guy started about the same time as me and still struggling to fund $20 million a year, which would have been $10 million back when I was doing it. And it's absolutely it's bonkers to me. And it's because we think we know everything. And the other mistake I see people make is that they have 1 year of experience, you know, 10 times or 18 times, and they just stay there. And there is no problem in your mortgage business someone else hasn't resolved. There's none. So the issue is like, okay, if you're smart and you want to save time, the faster someone else can show you how to do it, the quicker you're going to be successful. So I'm talking to my younger self. My younger self thought he was clever, right? The younger self was like, hey, I don't need somebody to tell me to do that. I'll figure it out myself. You think that you know better than me. That was my problem. And it made it much more challenging for me when I first started out. Today, I would say to my younger self, look, get a coach. And the biggest changes, all the trajectory, the big bumps that I've made in my personal life, in my business life, have all come from finding a coach who's done something I want to do. Key thing, they've done it. And it's like, show me how to do it. And then I have this philosophy of copy, paste, edit. Copy their best ideas, paste them into your business. Don't fight them, and then edit them. It's way faster. And I think even at my age now, like when I was, I wouldn't even read the directions putting IKEA furniture together. It was terrible. I'd be like, I don't need that. I'm smart. You know, get the whole thing put together. One of the panels is backwards. Take the whole stupid thing apart. You know, flip the panel over, put it all back together. I don't got time for that. So if I could go back and say to my, you know, younger self 18 years ago, I'd be like, dude, get a freaking coach or I'm going to smack you. That's the first thing. The second thing I would tell myself is to get a CRM and set up your own CRM and make sure you own it. Really important that you actually own this thing because, you know, often you can get given these things by your company that you're with, but I say that's like building your business on someone else's land. You build your house on someone else's land. It's like, man, I've seen so many, and you may be at that company forever. Maybe you found the perfect company. You love it. You're going to be there forever. Awesome. Good for you. Probably not likely, but if anything changes with either the company that you don't like and or your situation, it can be an absolute nightmare if you don't own your CRM. And so the second part I would say after getting a coach, the second thing I would tell myself is get a CRM. And if you don't want to think like right now, especially if you're newer, you're like, well, which one should I use? There's so many different options. At the end, I'll tell you two that I really like. But the simple way to do this is just use a spreadsheet and Trello. So a spreadsheet to basically track your files, where they're at. And then once you have them in a spreadsheet, you can actually ingest it into pretty much any CRM out there. And then Trello, I like for tracking files at each stage. So it's very simple. The The pros of this is that you can get this set up literally in a half an hour because you don't need a whole lot to do it. The cons of this are you can't build in automations. It's harder when you start to scale a team. But in the beginning, I would absolutely do this. Now, I do know there's some people out there that run their whole business off a spreadsheet, and God bless them. And I'm thinking of one of my friends, Jim DeLucas. And Jim DeLucas does a lot of mortgages. I think Jim, if he had proper systems in place and team, he'd probably, instead of doing 600 mortgages a year, he'd probably do 1,000. And you may be like, well, he doesn't need to. No, he doesn't. So he can tell me that, you know, F off, Scott, I don't need to do it because 600 mortgages a year is just fine. You are probably not Jim DeLucas. Just like I'd say to you, you know, Michael Jordan can dunk from the free throw line doesn't mean that you're going to dunk from the freezer line, right? Like, that's an exception. He's an exception to the rule. Most of you should have some kind of a system that is a bit more sophisticated, in my humble opinion. And the other thing about CRMs you got to think about is there's actually three parts. Most people don't realize this. There's the before, during, and after. And the mistake people make is they only focus on usually the during, which is the live deal. So that's the, you know, whatever submission platform you're using. And what you need to think about, though, is there's actually, you either can have to use three different tools. That's can be a bit cumbersome, or use a tool that you can do all three. But you've got leads. So these are people that you haven't, you know, they've got reached out to you. You put them in, you've got to have some way to stay in touch with them. You haven't actually had a discovery call. You don't have an application. If you're not tracking those, it's going to cost you money. The second is during. So the file goes live. This is usually your submission platform, but you also need to track stages in that thing. You know, what needs to happen at each stage. And then after, once that file funds, what are you going to do with it? As to my younger self, I'd just say set up a spreadsheet in Trello, and then, but understand that you have three databases here. There's three things you need to solve for. You don't need to solve for all of them right now. You can solve each one at a time and build them over, build them as you go. So that'd be there's also an episode, I'm going to put a link in the show notes to this, that I did back on the three most important ratios in your mortgage business. So you can go back and have a listen. I talk about the ratios between leads, between applications and closings. And it's actually, I break that down so you can understand that. That's just like a little bonus. You can go check that out. So first piece of advice, I'm sitting there, you know, drinking coffee, looking at my younger self, going, my God, you look young, Peckford. Your first thing you're going to do, Scott, is you're going to hire the best coach you can afford, and you're going to listen to them and copy, paste, and edit everything into your business. The second thing you're going to do is set up a simple CRM, at least to get going, so that you don't lose any files. Because that is one of the top regrets that when I talk to anybody who's done this business for more than, you know, 5 years, and I say, what's your biggest regret? They're like, I should have set up a CRM sooner. What a mess it was. Because here's the problem. When you're brand new, you actually have time. So you're like, it's not that big a deal. And you don't have that many files. So you think you better keep it all in your head, but eventually your business will spike and you'll be like, oh my gosh, now I got to go back and clean this up. And I don't remember these situations. Just start it from the beginning. Keep your life simple. That's the second thing. So the third thing I would tell you is to hire a fulfillment person as soon as you possibly can. And if I was starting over brokering today, I would hire them right now. Even though I don't broker at the moment, I've not done brokering in the last several years. So I've focused on coaching as well as the brokerage. But if I were starting my brokering again, I would not even start without having help, because I want to spend time going to find business. And so that's the second biggest regret people tell me is, like, Scott, I waited too long. I was doing 100 files a year. I was doing 120 files a year, and I was burning myself out. And my spouse hated me. And then it was like, I had to get help. By the way, we did the 10 Loans a Month Academy, we helped more brokers go from 10 million to 20 million or from 20 to 40 million. And they would come in to see us and be like, Scott, like, what do we do? And it was the same. It was the same game plan every time. And at the end of it, it was map out your process. So all the steps in the process, what happens at each stage, because it's a recipe. If the recipe's in your head, nobody else can follow it. And then step two is you need to hire help to take a bunch of those tasks off your plate. If you do those two things, you scale your business. If you do, like, literally, that's how you go from 10 million to 20 million, the quickest, and it's actually easier. So here's the psychology that I see when I talk to people, is that they're like, I'm worried about the cost. What is it going to cost me? And it doesn't take me that much time anyway. Sometimes it doesn't, but sometimes it takes you a lot more time because there's a problem. And now you're frigging with it. And you're like, it doesn't take me that long to make prep documents for signing. No, except when it doesn't, right? It doesn't take me that long to do this. No, except when it doesn't. And then when your prospecting drops, and here's what will happen. Like, it's literally, I could graph this out. You're going to go out, you're going to do the prospecting, get the business going. You're going to get files. Your business is going to go up. You're going to feel like, man, everything's awesome. I'm crushing some files. And then all of a sudden, what's going to happen is those files are going to all close. You're going to look up and go, oh crap, my pipeline is just none. There's nothing. And now you're going to be like the roller coaster. Now I got to go out and find more business. The way you eliminate that and how you bump, and even my friend there that's at 20 million, this problem is that it doesn't get any help. Like, doesn't have a clear process, not super disciplined, doesn't really want to have help because is afraid that nobody else can pull credit as good as him. It's bull crap, by the way. Anybody can do that. And so the reality is that the third thing I would tell myself is get fulfillment right away. And so fulfillment, I mean, you know, reviewing down payment docs, it can be an absolute time suck, you know, organizing your documents, labeling them, reviewing them. As they get more skilled, they can help you with more things. And so if you're worried about doing this, is what I tell people all the time. When I talk to somebody, one of our agents in brokerage, they, you know, go through the program, they end up graduating and then they start getting busy. They're like, oh my gosh, what do I do, Scott? And I'm like, well, I need to hire somebody. Oh, I don't know if I can afford it. I'm like, okay, let me ask you this. If you had 2 hours a day, 10 hours a week, do you, you know, 4 weeks a month, do you think you could find one more file a month? They're like, oh, no problem. They don't have 2 hours a day because they're too busy working their files. I'm like, so if you hired somebody at even $25 an hour, that's $250 a week. So you're talking, you know, what is that? $1,000 a month. Most of you make way more than $1,000 per file, and it is the fastest way for you to actually scale. And so I would tell you that if the number three thing that I would say to my younger self is Scott, and I took a, actually as a side note, I ended up having an assistant that was working for me at the beginning. She was a wonderful human, was not good at the job. And it took me like a year and a half to realize, for both of us to realize that, and her to find something that she was happier with, and me to find something that could actually help me. And so that's the other part. If it's not the right person, you're going to, you know, and I've gotten a lot better hiring since back then, but if they're not the right person, you're going to have to replace them. And so the thing you have to, there's two things. One, what would I do with 10 hours a week? Can I get more business? The answer is probably yes. The second thing is that if you hire somebody for you that's starting off, especially if it's a part-time scenario, is that you're not paying them, you know, $20,000 a year. You're paying them for 2 weeks at a time. So you don't have to be in your head like, oh my gosh, that's $26,000 a year or whatever. It's like, no, it's not. It's, you're only paying every 2 weeks. So if you think of it that way, it's like, well, okay, so let's say this experiment, I don't believe you, Scott, I don't think it's going to work. You trust me, if you get good fulfillment, your life is going to be completely changed. But just test this, do it for a month, after a month, I promise you, you'll end up being like, oh my gosh, I should have done this sooner. So that's the three things that I would tell myself if I were starting over. The two tools that I would look at right now. So if you're looking at CRMs, back to this whole, don't build your business on someone else's, you know, on somebody else's land. It's your business. I can't tell you how often, I posted that recently on my Twitter. I'm just learning Twitter, or X now it's called. And I shared it on Instagram, and somebody messaged me and was like, oh my gosh, Scott, like, this is perfect timing. I just changed brokerages and I was using the company CRM, and my previous company is marketing to my clients. And I was, and this is a message they sent me, and I was like, I wish I could say this is the first time I've ever seen it. It's not. It happens all the time. And you would be insane not to own your own CRM, because the people are doing business with you. They're building relationships with you. And I hope you love the company that you're with. If you're not, you can talk to us. Bing. That's my little ask there. But if you do love the company you're with, but even if you do, using their tools is a massive, massive risk. And so the two tools that I like, there's two of them, brokeredge.ca. And My Broker Pro. They're both excellent CRMs. They got some differences in how they do things. But what I like about setting up a CRM is that you can add in. So with the spreadsheet, you can build automations. People tell me, yeah, okay, sure. The real techie guy who's there will tell me, well, Scott, you can use Zapier and blah, 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 blah. I don't care. You don't need all the hassle of that, because Zapier breaks all the time. What you need is something that just works and something that talks to the different submission platforms, so that when your data comes in, it's actually in your CRM and you can track things and have checklists and stage notifications. So those are two that I really like. There's lots of them out there. Those are two. They're not that expensive. And this is for my Canadian listeners anyway. There's lots of, you know, if I was in the US, Jungle is pretty good for US listeners, but that's what I would tell myself. Okay, quick recap. So, Scott, you're sitting down, you've traveled in the DeLorean, you're sitting there. Three things, Scott: hire a coach, listen to them. Do not think that you know more than them. Copy, paste, edit everything they tell you in your business. You will get there way faster. The second thing is start tracking your files, use a CRM, and it can just be a Trello and a spreadsheet to start. It doesn't need to be complex. And the third thing is, the quicker you hire help, the faster your business will grow and you'll have more fun and do the part you like. Hopefully you found that useful. Thank you so much for the, I don't know who gave me that question because they're all anonymous at the roadshow, but it was a great question. It got me thinking. I was like, oh, this is a fun question to play with. Thanks for listening. Hey, I'm Scott Peckford. Hopefully you found this useful. As I always say, there's no problem in your mortgage business that someone else hasn't already solved. Your problem is, who's got the answer? Hopefully this podcast provides you some of the answers. Thanks for listening, and I will see you on the next episode.